PER and polyfluoroalkyl substances, or PFAS, are a class of thousands of synthetic chemicals that have been produced by companies for decades to make products resistant to water, heat, and stains.
All around us are the products of modern chemistry.
PFAS are harmful, and they're all around us. What we know. We know that PFAS bioaccumulate in our bodies and persist in the environment. Nearly everyone has been exposed to these toxic substances. Most people in the United States have one or more specific PFAS in their blood. We know the most about PFOS and PFOA, two PFAS that affect the human immune, endocrine, and metabolic systems, and are linked to various cancers, diseases, and health issues, including pregnancy complications and low birth weights. Ongoing research suggests that other PFAS have similar health impacts. Not only are PFAS harmful, they are nearly impossible to eliminate.
It's almost impossible.
PFAS, also called forever chemicals, are persistent chemicals due to their strong carbon-fluorine bonds, making them difficult to treat, remove, or destroy. And consequently, they cycle through the environment. It's not just airports and military bases where the firefighting foam AFFF was used, or factories that use or manufacture PFAS, but landfills, incineration facilities, wastewater treatment plants, all of these can release PFAS, contaminating land, air, and drinking water supplies, even food grown in farm fields. The EPA set a lifetime health advisory level of 70 parts per trillion for PFOS and PFOA in 2016, and is now working on drinking water standards for these two chemicals. But many states that discovered PFAS contamination have relied on new research to set their own lower limits on many PFAS. Across the country, many more communities will discover many types of PFAS contamination. The EPA will soon begin monitoring for 29 PFAS in drinking water. There is no treatment for PFAS exposure, nor any recommendation for safe exposure levels for each of the thousands of PFAS. And a blood test for PFAS does not offer insight into potential health problems. At this moment, only PFOA and PFOS have been phased out of production in the United States, but they're still manufactured in other parts of the world. And there are concerns that replacement PFAS are just as harmful. There are thousands of PFAS that we don't know enough about and don't even know how to reliably detect. States have regulated some PFAS in drinking water, food packaging, and consumer products. They've restricted use of PFAS firefighting foam and sued manufacturers. But a problem of this scale requires a systematic approach. Research is being conducted to better understand PFAS, but the evidence is clear. Trace amounts of many PFAS still threaten our health.